Hey, how's everybody doing, man? We were so excited about the first episode. We're going to do another one. We're going to do episode two of Shooting the Shit, Sinister and Beast here. We had a lot of good feedback. We got so excited about the questions you guys were asking. And if you have any questions,
ask it in the comments.
Put it in the comments below. We're getting, you know, we're not big techie guys. Martin is. I'm not.
I never said I was techie, but.
You're techie. But we are going to get, we want your questions about the last episode. Any question? We did have some cool questions that were emailed to us about the band practice stuff and the stuff about the ticket sales at the Webster.
Oh, yeah.
It was pretty cool. So our show is about two musicians. We've been doing this for quite a bit. We would just want to explain ourselves about the music scene and the scene we came from and the scene we're in now and just cool things behind that musicians talk about and go through and on a daily basis.
Yeah, basically just, you know, it's like our experiences, yours, mine, and just how it used to be here in Connecticut, how it is now, and how it might be. I don't know if there is even going to be a scene in Connecticut. Yeah,
you know what? It's tough because there's not too many venues now.
No, and there used to be a lot. Well, when I say a lot, I mean enough for everybody to be able to go to on a regular basis.
Right, that's what I mean. Back in the day, we had, I think it was geared more towards, we were original bands playing then.
Oh, yeah, I mean, there wasn't a lot of cover bands playing back then. It was a lot of original bands, and that's one of the reasons I went, because listen to a cover band, I can turn the radio.
What I mean. So there was a lot of more opportunities if you had original music. I mean, a lot of the original bands played a cover here and there, but it wasn't more, it was more on playing your originals.
It was, yeah. I remember years ago when we did a show at Toad's Place, we actually did a cover of Anthrax Only.
There you go. But
people thought it was our song for a long time. I'm like,
well, that's what it is, because it's that underground music we were listening to.
Exactly, yeah, I know.
Indians, Anthrax.
Indians.
We played Indians. People were like, what is this, man?
I remember seeing Anthrax in Dublin on the Indians tour.
Yep.
And he comes out wearing that big headdress. I'm like, what is this?
Yeah. No. Well, that's what I mean. That goes back to the underground, because people thought, oh, man, that's a cool song you guys did. No, it's not ours, but, you know.
Yeah,
I mean?
But it's like, it just shows that the scene was always there if you sought it out. It wasn't very, you know, commercialized, really, at that point.
Exactly.
Right. Like, we all knew who the bands were, the songs, everything, but it was like, you'd pull up next to somebody in a car, you're playing something like, who's that?
Exactly. Like, especially that, like Anthrax, and because what did everybody's got Whitesnake on.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that's the popular band, that's the commercial band, but we're listening to Anthrax.
Yeah.
You know?
I know. It's like, it's crazy. I mean, but I was listening to, on the way here, I was listening to old school Van Halen.
Yeah, you were telling me that. So what song, do you know what song you're listening to?
I was listening to Panama.
Okay.
Panama was like, just as I'm pulling in the parking lot here.
Yeah. A little newer one, yeah.
Well, to me, you know, that's my period of that.
Right. See, I go back to Van Halen 1 and 2 and, you know, when it first was the craziness. And
I didn't get introduced to them until 5150.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh,
I was a late bloomer.
You were. We're going to have to get you some of these albums to play on.
Well, I got them now, like Diver Down and stuff like that. It's all great stuff, you know, Eruption. Like, that is just ridiculous.
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah, that's, you know, that's kind of one of the bands that influenced me, actually, growing up, too. It's like, you heard this guitar player and this sick, another great producer. Van Halen 1 and 2.
1 and 2.
1 and 2 is a sick produced album.
Even one of the best produced albums, I think, by them, for me at least, is Balance.
Balance?
Yeah. The one where, you know, you get the kids on that seesaw-looking thing, whatever.
Oh!
Like a gold cover.
Oh, yes.
With Sammy Hagar.
Yeah. Okay.
Yep. That was a great album. Production on that was good.
See, then we can go through the whole thing. Is that Van Halen with Sammy Hagar? Or is it Van, you know what I mean? There's,
well,
the two Queensrÿches, the two Van Halens, you know?
You're going to have different opinions.
You are. I like Sammy Hagar doing Van Halen. I don't have a problem with it.
I do, too.
I do.
You know?
I think he brings a little bit more flair to it, but.
But definitely David Lee Roth had a lot of good stuff.
Oh, yes.
You know, I mean, he really. He shone in a lot of songs, but I think Hagar brought them out you know, bigger. I think.
Taker, yeah, he was more vocally talented, let's say, maybe.
Didn't you think?
I'm trying to be nice.
Sorry, Dave.
David Lee Roth could do karate chops all day long, but
I can't do those.
Yeah, yeah, me neither. But yeah, Sammy Hagar, yeah, he's just got a tone to him that's awesome.
Yeah, and he plays guitar, so he can be right.
And he plays guitar. Yeah, yeah. I don't know if Dave ever played. I've never seen him.
He's too busy jumping around
playing. I'm just a gigolo.
Everywhere I go,
people. The band was like, "What are we doing right now? What happened? You better be on Broadway, man."
But I mean, it's like you just didn't expect stuff like that.
No, you didn't. Right.
And I actually like that song.
It's cool. They got a lot of cool songs. They do another one, Happy Trails. Or
oh, yeah.
Happy Trails to you. It's like a what? But everybody sings it at the concert.
I know.
They all know the words.
It's like what's his face? Corey Taylor. He does, you know, SpongeBob thing in the middle of his
show. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Lives in a pineapple under the sea.
That's cool.
It is cool. I mean, it's different something different. Stuff. Yeah, but it just proves, you know, we're all big idiots and kids, you know.
It's we like, are.
You know, we're serious, but it's kind of like, you know what? You sing this, you know, SpongeBob. We're going to sing it.
Right. A lot of people don't know, like, if we don't have as musicians, if we're not doing music or something with music, we almost don't feel right. We don't feel normal.
Yeah, we don't.
We're off.
Yeah.
People are like, what's the matter with you? I'm like, I don't even know. Oh, wait a minute. I haven't done music in like 3 months. Maybe that's why.
Or anything involved
with music.
I mean, even this, you know, we're not, you know, singing and playing guitars or anything. We're just sitting here talking about music. But
it's,
we're around stuff that you would see in a studio.
Right.
So it's familiar.
Right in our comfort zone.
Yeah, exactly.
Gadgets and mics and cords. And
yeah. Well, enough about me.
Oh, yeah. Let's talk about you.
Let's talk about your football season.
Oh.
Because I did say we would talk about this, but we're not going to talk about this for the next hour.
He said, we'll talk about it, but we're not making
we'll touch on it.
Not making a whole show about the NFL.
No, we're not.
I said, fair. Fair enough.
Okay.
Yeah, so NFL season did kick off, and they did, I guess, their first game in Brazil last night.
Brazil?
Was it Brazil? Yeah, Brazil.
Wasn't there a game a few weeks ago in Ireland?
And let's talk about it. Yeah, first game was in Ireland, so I skipped that game.
How did that even end up?
I don't know, but it was very cool, so...
I didn't watch it.
Yeah. You know what was cool is like all the sports shows that do, you know, broadcast about the NFL.
Yes.
They were broadcasting in these small pubs.
In the Ireland?
Pints of Guinness. Getting shit faced, man. I mean, bad. Like, this was like, they're like, please don't drink another one. He's over there chugging. I don't want to say the guy's name.
Well,
he's hilarious.
If you want to drink, it's a good country to go to.
It looks so fun.
Yeah.
They had the Irish band sitting next to him playing.
Yeah, doing
the God, man. I love that music.
Well, you can see that a lot, especially in the west of Ireland.
Yeah.
Weird, and people just sit down with, you know, instruments, start playing.
There's something about that music that just makes you happy.
Sometimes, but some of it's kind of like too diddly-eye for me. It's like, shut that shit off.
See, I don't know this. What do you mean by that?
It's kind of like, all right, so let's take...
No, I'm just learning something now.
So let's take Honky Tonk. Like way back woods honky tonk.
Okay, right. You know, we were talking about that last time.
Yeah, we did. Take that and throw Irish music on.
Oh, okay.
It's like, shut up.
I get it. Yeah, it gets a little annoying.
Yeah, but I mean, people will go and listen to this over and over and over again. It's like, I don't know, nails on a chalkboard to me.
Oh, okay. Interesting.
Yeah, I'll play it for you sometime. You'd be like, shut up.
Yeah, let's put it on. Maybe we put a little up. We'll put it on this show. Hold on. We got to get our leprechaun hats on first. Oh, we're going to have props and everything on this show.
Where is me crocking gold?
Oh, my God. My lucky charms. It's magically delicious.
Somebody years ago, and I can't remember his name.
We got Martin going now.
He used to come to our practices.
He can't even talk. I love it.
He used to bring me a box of Lucky Charms.
No, he didn't. Was he being funny?
I don't know.
Oh, man.
I'm crying.
Oh, Jesus. What, just like a friendly gesture? You know what? Every episode I'm bringing a box of Lucky Charms.
Oh, my God.
With a bowl, so you can actually have some.
Anyway,
So let's talk about, we talked about me last time. Let's talk about.
Thank God we got over football.
How yeah, football's over. We're done. I love football, but I can't go into it because I'll just go left. So we're going back to Martin. Martin, how did you get started in the music scene, and how did you, what made you get into music?
I think what made me get into music was I went to a concert once. I forget who it was. But it was on a big stage, like a Webster type deal. And I was just blown away by this. And I'm like, all these people are here to see this. This is amazing. I want to do that. You know, okay, and then from there, it was like you got bitten by the bugs. And just from there, I just got together with a couple of friends and we, you know, set up a band.
Yeah.
You know, like we talked about last
That's
week.
That's what I'm saying. Like, it's like you've seen these guys. Well, we had, did you have MTV back? I don't know.
We had something like MTV. I think it was Music Television America. It was hosted by some Irish guy.
Okay.
But it was a similar.
But even back then, remember the top 40 would only play during the day. Any of the, metal only had a couple hours on a Saturday night.
Yeah, it was like a censored music.
Yeah, you know? like
it's like the PMRC almost got their hands on it. Get away from that.
Devil's music.
Devil's music. Get a body.
My God. That's what I'm talking about.
But it's not devil
like
music,
that. You know, everybody thinks metal, this. We're all crazy nuts and we are, but
yeah, you have to.
We're normal people.
Yeah, really, but I think metal talks a lot about issues.
It does.
Like serious issues.
Right.
You know, like whether it be environmental, whether it be, you know, mental, anything. But it's like, it's not, you know, I think.
There's a lot of mental awareness in rock and metal music.
Oh,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
A lot of really suicide. I mean, everybody talks about everybody help. All the festivals I go to, it's all based upon that. If you need help, you want to talk to somebody.
Yeah, I mean, and that's good.
It is good.
But it's like, you know, that's like metal healing the wound.
Yeah. No, it is.
It is.
It's such, that's what I'm saying. Like, people don't understand how tight the rock metal family is. You know what I mean?
It's real tight.
It's tight, man. You know, anybody would help anybody out at any time. Like,
well, that's the thing. It's like a family.
It is a family.
But the band is the family, too. I mean, we were talking about that and we're going to do something like that.
We're going to go into living with a band. I don't know if we should get into it this.
Yeah, you know what? Let's get into it a little.
You want to?
Yeah,
okay.
Why not? You know, I think we'll hopefully people.
Let's touch on it then. Yeah, so
get a kick out of it.
Even a lot of people that come by here and see the studio and just people, just to see people's reaction, because they're not around the stuff all the time.
Right.
And the average person just walks in with their eyes like,
whoa.
Look at all these cabinets and
like a Bill and
drums. And yeah. Like but we're used to it. But
yeah.
And, you know, and dealing with. So back before when we were younger, we had no problem ever getting together. You know what I mean?
No.
That's all we ever wanted to do.
Like,
you know, we're getting in that band room. We're gonna learn. And we're going to stay there.
We're going to stay there until we know it.
Until we know it.
Yeah.
We're not leaving. Nobody's leaving.
No.
No. And they didn't want to leave.
Lock the doors.
Lock the doors, but nobody wanted to leave.
No, and that's the thing. You know, but it's like, then there you got to the point then where, like, get me out of here.
Right.
I got something going on. I got to wash my hair. Something.
I got to eat Lucky Charms.
Oh, God.
My Lucky Charms are calling.
Do not write comments about
it. Listen, I know. It's going to blow up. Martin, look at this one. It's a clover. So talk about your experiences being in a practice environment with a bunch of dudes. And how it goes.
Like, well,
take me through a band practice with Martin. Go ahead.
So Martin shows up.
Yep.
Maybe one other guy. And we're waiting.
Okay, I'm already out. We're exactly the same. And we're waiting. Go ahead.
And I'm still waiting. So, what do you think of that show, dude, tonight, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, small talk.
Yeah.
Try not to get pissed.
No,
because nobody else is there.
Yeah, and then you're like, okay, come on. Got an hour to go. So, but then everybody else would roll in, you know, come up with the excuses. You know, I had to do this, I had to do that. I just forgot. But then you would get into playing, and that was actually the nice part, because once, it's like everybody forgot about things on the outside.
Yes.
You just got into this mindset.
Right.
And you just started practicing coming up with ideas. But then you get to a certain point where somebody else had a different idea for a different part of the song. That's when hell breaks.
That's when all hell breaks.
Yeah, because it's like everybody expects you to have an opinion and put your input into it.
Part of the problem with that. Some people, I don't know if they just not listening to the tempo of the song.
That's possible.
And just write a part that doesn't even.
Oh, I've had songs written where I was like, you want me to come in where?
Yeah, that's my point.
You know, it's like you wrote
You've
this.
You've got to have a little bit of structure and timing of what we're writing.
Yeah.
You can't just put a spare part in there. Call them spare parts.
But then you have to argue why this needs to be changed.
Right.
And it's like, it's blatant because I can't come in and sing at this spot because it just, it's not there.
Doesn't go. There's nowhere for me to jump in.
No, but they people, you know, musicians, like guitarists, bass, whatever, yeah. They look at the singer like, we don't know. Huh?
I get it. No, because I do both ends of it, right? You play guitar too, you know.
Yeah.
You have to create that space for the singer to sing.
You do. And being a singer, you also, yep. You understand that.
Yes.
And I sometimes I kind of feel bad for the guitarist and the drummer because they're not singers.
Right. Don't understand it. No. Really, but it's such a cool part.
Yeah, it was.
It is, yeah.
It was a cool part.
It was.
Just not for me.
Not for this. You can play it all you want.
At home.
At home. Not here.
But yeah, here. I mean, you would definitely get into arguments and stuff like that. But then again, that brought out some of the best music.
Yeah, it did.
You know, we had.
Well, that's what it is. When you go to battle about something,
yeah,
like that happened in the studio with us one time with Enemy Remains. We went in and it was our first singer, and I told the singer flat out. I says, "If you're recording that, I'm leaving the room. I don't want nothing to do with it." I did. I left.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh wow.
Yeah. I took the thing off. I said, "If you're gonna." And Zimmerman's kind of like, okay. I said, because I said, it does not fit. It does not go. I told you before, it's not going to work.
No, I mean, and that's the thing.
And it's the thing, because there was no vibe to the song at all. It was just over something that was like, I'm like, that's not good.
But then you have to see, as the vocalist, right, as the front man.
Right.
Or woman, whichever it is. You have to be able to feel the song, because if you feel that song and you're on stage, you're going to feed the audience.
That's what I was
And they're going to give it back to you.
He was just singing something that just like, do you feel that? I don't feel that.
Yeah, I feel nothing. I
feel nothing, bro.
Yeah, it's like, oh, yeah. La, la, la.
Yeah, okay, great, yeah.
Yeah, you know, whereas I want to be able to, you know, I feel so good about this song that if I'm hitting a high note here, I want to be able to hit an even higher one.
Exactly.
You know, that's what I want.
If I can't play that part twice on a rewind and listen, it's gone.
Oh, yeah.
I can't listen to it.
Yeah, I mean, you have like, after even like doing your scratch recordings in the studio,
right?
You listen to them over and over and over again,
right?
To find out, you know, what it is that you think you did wrong and you don't like. But then what's funny is when the albums are actually produced, I listen to my old ones and I'm like, could have done this.
Well, we'll go on all into that too after the album. Oh my God, we should have did this.
Why is it slow?
Yeah, we should have did it 10 times quicker here. But yeah, no, that's a good point. It's just like finding the pocket for the singer and getting along with the part with everybody.
Yeah, you know I mean? It's getting along is key, but it is like a marriage.
Right.
You know, you have your good times, your bad times. And then,
right.
You know, there's stuff in between. And then, you know, it's when somebody finally like leaves a band, it's like, oh, no.
Yeah.
You know, it's like then you have to do this search to find the replacement.
Yeah.
One that's just as good, if not better.
And gets along with everybody.
Well, that's the key.
That's the whole key. I don't care how good you are. If I can't sit in a room with you, you're out.
Yeah. No, it's like, yeah, I mean, I've worked with musicians over the years, and, you know, they've all been great friends, but some are just like, oh. You know.
I played with a couple of guys just like, you know, I play lead guitar. I'm in the front of the stage, in front of the singer.
Right.
What? No, you're not. You're in the band. You're staying back with the back line with us.
Well,
I'm the lead guitar player.
Yeah, but I'm the one singing.
Yeah. Oh, I swear to God, I had a guy like that. I was like, this is the lead singer.
Yeah.
You're on stage left.
There's an actual, you know, like, thing, rules to being on stage.
There is.
I mean, they're broken all the time, but it's kind of like, you know, you have a singer, you want to put the singer up.
You got it.
You bring your guitarist back slightly, your bass player, well, do they exist anymore? They always seem to be disappearing.
Should be behind the drummer, maybe. No, I'm kidding, bass players. Don't send me any hate mail. I play bass too.
Send him Lucky Charms.
Yeah, send me Lucky Charms. Relax. This is a joke.
Was it?
I don't know.
I mean, we talk about, we're just going to go back and forth with you and me. And you
Yeah. We're just trying to, these first couple episodes, we're just trying to get you guys to know who we are and why we can say what we want to say, because we kind of have a little bit of experience doing this. And it's like, I had somebody in, and my sister in the, singing in the booth the other day.
Yeah.
Just to have her reaction of what we know and how to do things. It's right. A cool feeling.
It is. Know? Well, it's cool when you know that you know you can do it.
Right.
You know, you're not going in there and going, wait a second, hang on.
That's aggravating.
Yeah, no, it's like, you want to be able to go in and sit at a board or something.
Yeah, shoot a, yeah.
And do
some vocal tracks.
Yeah, and not even, have to think about it.
Don't think about it, right.
Yeah, it's like, it's a muscle memory.
But it takes a lot of time to learn how to do that.
Oh, God, yeah.
You know, because we've spent hours trying to figure out the software we're running, and you know how aggravating that gets when you're writing a part.
Yeah.
And you forgot how to do an edit or something on your software, and
right.
It just takes the steam out of the room.
Yeah, well, it's like, well, like when I'm editing down the video for this and putting it all together, so I forget, I have to do this before I do this.
Right.
And then sometimes I end up going all the way back to the beginning of the podcast. I'm like, that's what I was supposed to do. That's why it doesn't sound the way it's supposed to,
right.
You know?
Yeah, so, that happens with music, right?
Yeah, it does. It happens all the time. And even with the instruments themselves, they have to be set up.
The guitars sound different here. Like,
yeah.
When we got to use the, creating the same track and all the effects are the same. But back in the day, you had to load that manually and be like, or if you didn't play, because, back in the, let's talk about that.
Right.
Back in the day, we recorded on 2-inch tape.
Yes, we did.
Okay.
That was heavy.
I'm going to Maybe on the next break. We'll bring one in here. But
we got a lot of stuff to bring
you
in.
You had to play, everybody in the band had to play the whole song all the way through.
Yes.
Because you're on a 2-inch reel tape.
Yes.
There was no cut, paste, put the dirt. Nope.
No, there was none of this, like you said, cut and paste. You know,
right.
There was cut and paste.
Yeah.
It was physical.
Physical.
You physically, literally had to
cut the 2-inch tape.
Tape it back together.
Tape it back together.
On my, oh, I used to do that with cassettes.
Yeah.
We talked about that last week.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. Like, it was a whole process. Because, and engineers would be like, no, just play it again. Like, some of our songs were 10-minute songs back then.
Yeah, but I mean, it's like, so, and they were, the tapes were expensive. So
yeah,
you
well,
had to really, you know, like, look at your time in the studio and be practiced, like, unbelievably before going in there. You couldn't go in there and just not be prepared.
Right.
Because you're a waste of money, you're wasting tape, and it's like, there's no
money. And then, like he says, you only bought, we're only buying two-inch reels.
Right.
You got to fit everything on there. Now you're, like, downing tracks. You're, because every track takes up more space.
Yeah, yeah.
And we had, like, when we were using the big boards back then, you know?
Oh, those big boards were awesome.
Oh, my God, they were awesome. The sound on those.
People probably look at us and go, what are they talking about? Awesome. Like, you have to go into a control room in the studio.
Yeah, you ever see like a big famous artist like me and Martin? And we walk into a studio and the board's bigger than
the room. Studio.
Yeah, it's a studio. It's huge.
it's like, you know, you look at it and you're like, this is overkill.
It is.
But
the guy sitting there doesn't think so.
No.
He thinks he needs more knobs.
Yeah, and more things to plug in.
Like a switch operator. Hold on!
That's what it always reminds me of, the switch operators in those old movies.
I'll get you the delay you need. Hold on a second.
Hang on a second. Let me just dial it in here.
Patch it in. Hit 49 buttons over here, and he knew exactly where everything is.
Yeah. You remember the old tape echo chambers?
Yes. Right.
But you people don't know what they are.
Yeah.
It was a cassette that would go around, and it would give you the effect, you know? So,
or even a, here's a little trick, on a reverse cymbal hit.
Okay. No,
now they have, you just hit, put a plug in it.
Yeah, yeah.
You had to reverse.
You had to reverse the tape.
Reverse the tape.
You had to do what?
Yeah, you take the 2-inch tape, you put it over here, and you'll. It's great.
Yeah.
So many tricks, man. We're like, oh. And that was always my drummer's thing. He goes, we need a reverse cymbal here. I'm like,
that's the last thing I want to hear.
It take 3 hours just to hear.
But I mean, it does sound cool. But
it's wicked cool.
Back then, it took time.
It did take time.
You know, so it's like, oh, okay, whatever. You know, and then I could never figure out why I was so tired coming out of the studio. It was because of all the doing this and doing that. It's like, it was tiring.
You know what? It's so fun and mentally fun. And then, but it's just, you get so drained. And in your head, you start losing. We call it studio head.
Yeah.
You guys know what studio head is. It's listening to music for 12 hours straight. Just drum.
Yeah. And then it's like, you get to that point where it's like, you can't even think anymore.
You can't even think anymore. Everything sounds like mush.
Yeah. And it all sounds the same. And
it all sounds the same.
How does that sound? It's great.
Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah.
You go home and listen to it, and you're like, that sounds like
that. Sound like crap.
You go back the next day, fresh ears, we call it.
Yeah. Fresh ears, next day.
Next day, you're like,
all right, we're ready to go.
All right, Mark, what the hell was that we listened to? Like,
we
were already turning knobs and switching stuff.
I don't think you can get that today. Well, I suppose you could if you really wanted to, but now you just leave everything recorded. You know,
right.
You're not, you know, wasting tape. You're having, like, you know, scratch vocals, scratch guitars, whatever. You just leave them there on the computer.
Well, you know it is now because you got digital.
This is true.
You can do it. You can do a million tracks.
I know.
And still do more.
We were lucky we had 24.
You're right. Yep.
Go into a studio and you're like, 24 tracks?
We got 20.
Really?
But here's the thing. Back then, I don't know if you, your drummer was like that. Every drummer I played with has 75 drums.
Yeah.
Like, those are each tracks.
Yeah.
That's a different track.
It's a different track, a separate mic.
That's a separate mic, a separate track. So this is what we're teaching you. We're teaching you about studio stuff now. See?
Yeah.
See what we do? So every drum you have had a different mic.
Yeah.
And then you had On ours, we had a mic on top and a mic underneath. We had two mics.
Yeah, there's normally two mics. Yeah.
Double mics on the snare, double mics on the kicks.
Sometimes you'd have like double mics inside the kicks.
Inside the kicks.
With the pillows.
And then three mics across the room.
One overhead.
One overhead, two overhead sometimes, yeah, depending
on. Catch the cymbals.
Just to catch, we don't have enough cymbal sound. Let's throw four more mics up there. Like every other mic ain't picking it up.
All right, guys, we got two tracks left.
Yeah. Do the singing and the guitars on the last two tracks. Oh,
by the way, you're out of tape.
By the way, the bass player didn't make the tape. Oh, I'm back on the bass players. Hold on. We can edit him in.
No, we're not going to edit any of this out, but that was subliminal, I think it was.
See how everything just comes around, Martin?
Oh, God. We're going to music health.
Yeah, we are.
Yeah, there's going to be like a, you know, somebody commenting, you guys are idiots. What are you?
You hate every bass player.
Not all of them.
Not all of them. Some of you guys are good. I'm kidding, man. I'm kidding.
We are. We're kidding. We're kidding. Yes.
Like I said, this is Beast and Sinister. We're doing a new podcast educating you guys on like studio stuff we just did. You know, it's just life experiences and just to see people. Like I said, we'll start bringing some fans in.
I mean, I'd love to get a
just
fan
bring them in here in
just to get their perspective.
Yeah, I want to hear their question. Like, how do you guys go about this? Or do you know?
That'd be cool. Like interview us,
interview us.
You
right.
know, it's like because we can talk about music so much,
right?
And I hope we have a lot to talk about. I'm sure we do.
Yeah,
but you have somebody sitting in front of us saying, "Well, how how do you get into the studio?"
Right.
You know,
it's like, what's the first process of recording?
Right. Learn your stuff.
Know your song. Don't be learning a song in the studio.
Don't be doing that. It's like doing your homework in class.
Oh, go back to band practice. There's a part of band practice where some guys don't get this. You're not learning the part on my time. You should already did your homework and come in. If we just wrote it, that's different.
Yeah.
Do your homework.
Yeah. That guitar.
We were huge on that.
That guitar and bass that you have, that goes home with you.
It goes home with you, and you're like, we say, hey, work on that part. You got to work on it. Okay. Yeah. If you're doing the same problem in the next practice, now we have a problem.
Now we have an issue.
We have a big problem now.
No, there's
now everybody puts their instruments down.
Yeah.
You sit in the room, and you play for everybody.
I know. And it's like, and then.
Play your part, dude.
Yeah.
You should
have had this. I mean, I've had that thing where it's like, well, did you learn the part? Well, I didn't have time. Okay, you didn't have time the last time.
It's been 6 days. What'd you do for 6 days? I was busy.
Doing what?
Doing what? Then maybe you don't belong here. Because this is our life, man. This is our life.
You want to be a bass player?
You want to be a serious bass player? You got to practice. God.
We're not dissing on bass players.
You're sorry.
Really, no. It's just, this is what happened.
This is what happens when we get together.
Next time it'll be drummers.
Yeah. Well, we can do a whole show on drummers.
Oh, yeah, we can.
We'll make fun of ourselves, too. It's things we do.
Well, I make fun of myself all the time.
Yeah, you got to. You got to laugh about it. You too. You know, because I'm very, I write a lot of this stuff, and I'm very,
you're proud of it.
You're proud of it.
Yeah, it's like, all right, no, we're doing it my way.
Yeah, but it isn't. Like, sometimes I'll write the whole song, and I'll be like, here, present it to the band.
Yeah.
And if your part's better than my part, then it's making it in the song. That's all there is to it.
Yeah, absolutely.
If it makes sense and it vibes with it.
Yeah.
But usually I'll get, because I'll give the tempo to the band and be like, all right, kind of looking like this. You guys make it your own.
Right.
I always say that. Make it your own unless it sucks. Maybe I should say that. No.
I ain't mentioning nothing.
It's got to be good.
So I think most of the time, at least for singers that take control, like I was a singer that took control.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like I want to put the best into the song that I possibly can. So
it is because you're a singer that knows musical notes and plays guitar.
Right.
Not a lot of singers know that.
No, but it's kind of like I helped. Right,
create
the music so that the musicians would come to me with their parts. I'm like, that's nice, that's good, that's great.
But keep that.
But try this. You know, and I mean, eventually you would, after banging heads for a bit.
Exactly.
And then they'd come up to you going, "That sounded great." I'm like, I know.
And here's the thing, and nobody takes anything personal. You can't take nothing personal in band practice because after band, we're gonna have a beer together. We're gonna laugh. It's just It's all about the perfect part.
Yeah.
That's it.
It's just trying to get the best part to get out to people, because that's, at the end of the day, that's you. You want your fan base to listen to your music.
Exactly.
Because, I mean, I'm not saying there's no point in doing it. Yeah, there is a point in doing it if you're even not just putting it out to the public. But it's like, if you're putting it out to the public, put out the best product you can.
Exactly. Well, like we said, if we can't listen to it 40 times in a row, then nobody else.
Nobody else is hearing
it. Yep.
Yeah, not at all.
We used to go in the studio, finish a track. We would literally sit there, play it again.
Yeah.
When we love something, play it again.
Keep playing. Keep playing.
Play it again.
Yeah.
I couldn't get enough of it.
Yeah. I've had songs like that where I was like, I can't wait to get to practice to do this song a million
it's
times.
Cool. Yeah. You know what I mean?
I know. And it's just, and then.
And that's the validation of the perfect part, the perfect song. That's what ends up with. You're writing every part that you love.
Right.
By the end of that song you love.
Oh, yeah. That's, yeah.
You love that song.
And then that actually, you know, brings itself to the people live, because you've loved that song so much, you want to give everything you have into it for the audience, you know?
Like, totally.
It's key.
It is key.
You know, but it's...
But that's what makes you passionate about... That's why, you know, we write original music. Because we're proud of it, man. It's like...
Well, yeah, I don't
want to... That's our badge.
I don't want to be playing somebody else's song.
I can't.
I want them playing mine.
I know.
You know, actually, I
we can do a whole thing about that, you know, because you never went down that road either, did you? With the, I mean, we did covers here and there, but
we used to.
I didn't create a band to just play covers ever.
No, but it was funny. One show we used to play with another band, I forget their name, but it was so funny. It was like an homage to us. They actually played one of our songs.
Oh, that's cool.
I was like, that is cool.
That's cool. See, that's validation right there.
That's a local band playing a local band song because they liked it.
That's cool.
You know, so it's like it's making that impression on even your fellow band mates and friends, you know.
But that's what I mean. Like, we started, hey, let's learn a Van Halen song. Let's learn.
Well, you start with.
Everybody starts like that.
Yeah, stuff that you like to listen to.
But you know how many times I've been approached about, hey, dude, you want to do a cover band?
I've been approached about it many times.
I don't even hesitate. No.
I just say no.
No.
Because.
No, I don't.
I think I could sing a lot of it. I don't know if there's a lot of it I could sing, but I don't want to.
Exactly.
I want to sing my stuff because I'm comfortable with my voice.
Right. But don't get us wrong. You want us to learn? We'll play it. Actually.
Yes. Wait.
You see how this all sets itself up? So we're going to have a new segment on here. Yeah, we're going to have a new segment on here where me and Martin are actually going to leave these seats. We're going
to. You're going to go, yeah!
Yeah, you're gonna cheer because we're not talking anymore. We're gonna go in the other room to the live sound room.
We're gonna unchain the bass player.
We're gonna unchain the bass player from the wall. We'll be able to join us. No, we're actually gonna do some of the stuff we grew up on. We are gonna do some covers, rip them up our way.
Yeah, we are.
So
yeah, it's
we talked about this and we said, you know what, this would be
a good idea,
and we're gonna have guest musicians sitting in the other room. And you're not going to know who it is.
Yeah, we might not even know who it is.
We might not even know. So we're going to name the segment. We don't know the name of it yet, but we know.
We'll have to come up with a name for that. It's like, or even, you know, what we could do as well. It's like if you're a musician, you're out there, and you want to try and come in on this.
Yeah.
You know.
Hit us up.
Let us know.
Yeah. Hit us up.
Let us know. We can set something up.
And, absolutely.
Yeah, we're definitely going to do that, and we have it planned out. And it's, we don't have it planned out. Because we don't have plans.
We don't plan nothing. Except for our songs. We're very critical of our songs.
Yes. But yeah, we are going to do that. We are going to do a cover or two, three maybe, depending. But like Tom said, we're going to do it our own way.
Our own way.
But I think it'll be a nice...
And here's, that's another thing we could talk about. People doing... If you want to do the exact same cover... I've seen a couple of bands out there that make their songs... They put a different flair on it.
Sound of Silence.
All the silence.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. It's like, the first time I heard that song, I didn't like it.
I know.
I have a t-shirt that has a pint of Guinness on it. And it says, hello, darkness, my old friend.
No way. Yes. I want that shirt. But that's what I mean. Doing covers is cool. Doing it your own way is even cooler.
Yeah, because you're taking something that you want to cover.
Yeah.
but you want to put your own flair on it.
Yeah.
And I think that's amazing when musicians do that.
Yeah, that's because that's, we did it with one song. We did it with Enemy. We did it with a Break and Bend song.
Well, I think that's harder than doing the actual cover.
It is.
The simple reason is because you have that song ingrained in your mind.
Right.
How it goes.
Right.
And now you...
Well, people can't hear what you're hearing.
No.
I don't hear that song.
The voices.
Yeah, the voices that talk to us, Martin. Be like, Tommy, what do you mean we're not playing guitars in these parties? There's no guitars here. It's all keyboards. What?
All keyboards.
Doing keyboard strings, and then we're doing... Because I'll rearrange though. I don't want it to sound like... But I want it to sound like you know it's them.
Yeah.
But it's us.
But it, yeah, exactly.
It's us.
Putting your own spin on it, you know, and it's like... I know that song. It's kind of, when I came in here earlier, you had somebody playing on the radio. I thought it was Aerosmith or something like that, but
oh yeah, else. It was Bad Wolf.
Yeah,
doing okay, Aerosmith, but he made it his own.
Yeah, but you it was mean? Like that's cool.
It is cool,
you know. But yeah, so
I don't like these headphones, pissing me off. Aren't
yeah, you? Okay.
But we're gonna take another break, and we'll be back. We're gonna do some videos. We're gonna talk about more music. We're gonna talk about the live room. And the guest people, and you guys, make sure you like and subscribe and do all that fun stuff.
But, please do, because we want this to take off.
And yeah, we do. It's going to be pretty cool. Everybody's...
Well, we want to be able to do it for people to listen to, because otherwise we're just doing it for ourselves.
Yeah. No, we got nice feedback on the first episode. People were calling me I haven't talked to in 20 years.
Good.
Dude!
Do it again.
Awesome. All right, we'll be right back.
Be right back.
Oh, I should have got a 2-inch. I'll get it for the next segment. I want to show you the 2-inch reel tape.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I do have some in the other room.
We have to get that Walkman.
And the Walkman.
Yeah, if you remember the first episode, I hope you remember the first. I watch it every now and again. It's hilarious.
It is hilarious.
But, yeah, we talked about the Walkman and the little crappy headphones you got with them.
Yeah, that's...
And I think that's where my bass player thing comes from. Yeah, because you never heard the bass.
There was no bass in the Walkmans.
They were just...
It was an AM... rip your ears off. Like, how's it sound? Great!
Yeah, it's great!
It's great! Hold on. Let me take one ear off. Yeah, no, the technology was... It was not there.
No, but it was... It had potential.
I mean, look, you've got earbuds now. iPhone. Those things sound amazing.
They do, actually. I have the Beats, too.
The Beats?
I think they're better.
They're more bassier. Yeah. Yeah, they are.
I think they are.
So, Beats, if you're listening, you know, we're not, you know, we'd like to, if you want to sponsor us.
Hey, what? Hey, we like Apple.
We like Apple.
We like free stuff. I mean,
free
free stuff. So
we're gonna do the opposite of everybody else. Listen, I'm not sponsor us.
Yeah, sponsor us.
I'm not gonna say no. Yeah, hear all these guys on these podcasts.
I really don't want to get really sponsored
by Rode. Rode Procaster.
And we're not sponsored by McDonald's.
McDonald's. Or Coca-Cola. What? Coca-Cola.
McAfee.
My God. Just. Oh, God.
Must be something in the air today.
Yeah. So
lack of it, maybe.
Lack of it. Yeah. So we're going to, like I said, we're going to start getting some fans. And you guys, if you do want to come in, you comment down below, like and subscribe. Tell us your thoughts. Say, hey, listen, I'd love to come in and talk to you guys. Doors are wide open, right?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's like we'll sit you right here in front of us.
Yeah.
We'll put a camera on you.
Yeah.
That's the one thing, you will be on camera.
You will be on camera. There's no more just audio with us.
No, it's just, so if you're okay with that, obviously we are.
We are, yeah. We have no choice. We have to do it.
Yeah, we do.
But
yeah, if you want to come in, definitely just hit us up, leave a comment if you don't mind, and then, you know, tell us why you want to come in, and we'll have you come in, and we'll sit you down, and you can interview us.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's the best way for us to do it.
Especially all you bass players that want to get back at us. Come on in. We'll chat. We'll have a conversation.
You guys can stand on the other side of the wall.
Yeah, we'll talk to you behind the glass. You go over there. Kidding. We're kidding. We're kidding.
Just don't bring Lucky Charms.
Yeah. Bring Martin Lucky Charms.
All is forgiven.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
but yeah, this is Beast and Sinister. This is shooting the shit, and this is what this show is all about. Just having fun. Yeah, talking about cool music, and we're gonna put up some cool
videos. Well, we're not gonna play videos in the traditional sense. We're gonna play maybe 20 seconds.
Yeah, we're gonna give you a little clip. Yeah.
Obviously, we'll put up on the video who the band is, because there's a lot of bands that we listen to and have over the years that you just have never come in contact
about
with.
About Sabotage. Remember Sabotage? Hall of the Mountain King?
Yeah.
Another good...
24 hours ago, I was listening to that song the other day.
No, you weren't.
I was.
So you should be... You're mind blown right now.
Yeah.
Are you like, did he really just say Sabotage?
Yeah.
That's another band I used to play all the time in my car.
I played with them a bunch of times.
Did you?
Yeah. Remember Tuxedo Junction in Danbury?
Of course. Yes.
Played with them down there a bunch of times. Webster.
Okay.
Somewhere else, I can't remember where. But they're all cool guys. Like, John Oliva, cool guy.
Oh, hell yeah.
You know, but yeah, it's like, yeah, we're going to play stuff, video stuff. Like, I found a band the other day that I forgot about. Talisman.
Okay.
Jeff Scott Soto singing.
Oh.
Yeah.
I don't know that band.
Now you do.
Oh, I'm going to play that.
Yeah. I mean, this guy's a
beast. Got me on Jeff Scott Soto. I love that dude.
Yeah, he's a beast of a vocalist.
Yeah.
You know, but yeah, I found them the other day, and I was like, oh my God, I forgot about this band.
Right.
You know, it's like, and you brought up Trouble the first time on
Trouble.
The show. Yeah, I was like, I haven't listened to those guys in so long.
How about another local band we didn't talk about last time that kind of came out competing with Fate's Warning? You remember?
You guys?
Nope.
Oh, was it?
You better know who it is. You're in the studio with them.
What?
Yeah.
Well, back in my day.
Obsession!
Oh, God!
Come on, Martin! That's your boy, Mike Cera. Oh, yeah, I got him. He's speechless. Obsession, huge Connecticut band.
I forgot.
Man. Oh, man.
I'm just going to go home.
What was that, Martial Law? What was that song?
Yeah, Martial Law.
Martial Law, dude. Yeah.
Their
album was awesome, too. We're like, see them locally.
They're an amazing band.
Another one of my favorite bands, yeah.
And then Mike went off to Japan and joined Loudness.
Joined Loudness, yeah. Did he sing with Yngwie, too?
He sure did.
Okay, so Jeff Scott Soto sang with Yngwie. Yes. And then Mike, local guy.
Yeah, local guy.
25 minutes from here.
Yeah.
He's singing for Disney now, I think.
Yeah, he's doing something with them, I think.
Somebody said that.
Himself and John Bruno are doing something, I think, because John was in Obsession, too.
Hey, you know... Who might just be in our soundstage one day.
Hey.
Another, see what I'm saying? Another one. We have a lot of local musicians around. So that's what we're talking about.
Yeah, so we have a lot of local musicians who have done a lot.
A lot.
In the bigger things of music.
Yeah, but never got the steam because we'll talk to radio stations around here. We're playing Obsession.
We do have radio stations.
We do. We think.
We think, yeah.
We think there's FM still out there.
There's something out there.
But you got Metal Fortress Radio right here. We play all that shit. Plug.
Oh, my God. This has been too much of a roller coaster laughing session.
Oh, no. This has been a good session, yeah.
So we're getting close to the end. You want to talk about your football now?
Okay, so.
All right. So, anyway, folks.
That was the first Ireland game.
Yeah, I know.
That I called you. And you're like, what do you mean? You were like, I'm like, they're at this. He goes, I know that pub.
Yeah.
Dublin,
yeah. I forget the name you told me, but.
Yeah, I forgot too.
American football, for me, growing up, I got to see some of it on TV.
Okay. Because
they would play games in Wembley Stadium in London.
All right.
So the NFL.
Was it televised over there before?
Yeah. But then it actually picked up and got legs for a long time. I think it's still, a pretty popular game over there now. But I wanted to get into it. It's one of those things, kind of like I wanted to like this because it's supposed to be liked.
Yeah.
But I could never get into it.
Yeah. Probably
because I couldn't understand the rules. But yeah, I'll put baseball on for 6 hours.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, you like baseball. That?
Yeah. Love baseball.
That's awesome. A lot of people can't sit through baseball. It's relaxing.
It is relaxing. What it is, it's like you can go away and come back and nothing's happened.
I didn't miss a thing.
I didn't miss nothing.
It's the sixth inning? Wow. It's the same batter. It's the same pitcher.
Oh, my God. But, yeah, oh no. God. So we're gonna be losing Tommy to football.
Oh, yeah. This season. Yeah, I mean, I get very involved with football. I love football. I played football. I mean, that's what I used to play sports before I took the music path.
I couldn't play football.
No.
Look at me.
What do you mean? You could be a kicker or...
I could be the ball.
Nobody can touch you, man. Just run fast. There goes Marcus. Can't catch that bastard.
He's running fast today. Yeah, have you seen the size of the guys behind him?
Oh, my God. Funny, man. But yeah, the football season has started. I love football. I mean, I don't like my team anymore. I'm not going to talk about my team.
We won't ask you who your team is.
Yeah, don't. Patriots. Sorry. Sorry. Hate me more. Go ahead. I don't care.
I'm not a football fan, so I don't have a favorite team, but I have heard that the Patriots are pretty
terrible.
Not great.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, we had a good run,
Why doesn't Connecticut have a football team?
I don't know.
I mean, you got one team representing New England.
Which one?
When Patriots, right?
Well, yeah.
Every other state.
It's either your Patriots or Jets or Giants.
Well, that's state. Yeah, in Connecticut, yeah. It's like in New York.
Yeah, I think the Jets were supposed to come here. The Patriots were supposed to come here, and it was all just a bunch of bull.
Yeah, well, Yeah, Connecticut is called New Yorkachusetts.
I've never heard that.
Yeah.
Really?
You never heard that?
I did not.
I hope I didn't make that up because I think I heard it. I wouldn't have come up with something like that on my own.
Listen. Own it now. That's yours.
It's mine.
He made it. Yep. Martin created that.
It's like the McDonald's ad. They're talking about the snow. 5 inches of snow. Nah, Dustin.
Yeah. Dustin. Yeah.
Not sponsored by McDonald's, but yes, we would like to. Thank you very much. And Coca-Cola. Yeah.
You wanted to have a nice Coca-Cola.
Coca-Cola. All right, listen, we're getting to the end of this.
We are. We got to wrap this up.
I think so. We'll just, we'll say thanks again for tuning in or clicking in or keep clicking in. Comment, like, subscribe. Please subscribe because this is the only way we'll know that we're building content.
Right, right. We want to know you care or you hate us.
Yeah, and I mean, I know every other podcast says, subscribe and like. And love. Seriously, subscribe and like.
Yeah, no, we're serious. Yeah.
It's like...
Because we take this personal. Yeah, we're not just doing this for a gimmick. We're really taking the time out of our day and just trying to, educate you on some stuff. And then we're going to have some cool segments coming up, like with the live room. And
yeah.
We might bring you into the recording studio to show you a little process on how to track vocals, maybe.
There you go.
Why not?
All right.
How to track, what tracks, for, let's track a guitar track. Yep. Let's.
I know a guitarist and a singer.
I do know a couple guys that could help us out.
I know a guy.
I know a guy. Hey, I know a guy. I know a guy.
I know a guy who knows a guy.
I know a guy who knows a guy that knows the guy.
The guy.
The guy.
I gotta go see that guy. But
gotta go see the guy.
What?
For the other guy. I can go on and on with this. Right up my alley.
Forget about it.
Forget about it. We gotta go.
We gotta go. Bada boom, bada bing.
Bada boom, bada bing. And listen, like I always say, if you got nothing nice to say, don't say nothing at all. Be nice. Be kind.
Just make stuff up.
Or make shit up.
See ya.